quick thing on analog processing, you know, almost like a Carver Mead Renaissance. The brain is a pretty amazing, again, inspiration continually for the research in this field, whether it's Hinton or Kuhn or anyone. They keep going back to, well, gosh, look what the brain does that we don't yet do so well in our own processors. And Jeff Hawkins, in his book On Intelligence, sort of famously pointed out that the memory-centric approach to computation is what it's all about, right? For those in the crowd that are close to Intel, you know that the vast majority of transistors Intel manufactures are memory transistors. The vast majority on any Pentium processor, over 99.8% of all transistors, are for memory, all the cache memory that they lather on there. It sort of points a finger to the future as a memory-rich, memory-centric kind of architecture. The brain actually does this computation in the memory elements. And in the case of Mythic, they just give you a sense of how different this is, how you can get another 100-fold, 1,000-fold improvement in power per calculation. They basically take a flash memory array and turn it into an analog computational element. So the flash core is the same, just a 2D grid of floating gate flash memory transistors. They do a matrix multiply and add, so the multiplication step, multi-bit multiplication, and add in a single transistor. Right? Multiply, 8-bit values, add them up, one transistor. That, of course, is frame-breaking. You can't even fathom how that would work in a digital computer. And all the memory is in the same thing as well. And you store the results as you go. So it's kind of a radically different way to do computation in memory that is much closer to the way neurons work in the brain and could allow, what this will enable is the Internet of Things, basically putting smart little inference engines in everything. What the NVIDIA CEO anticipated will soon be trillions of inference engines out at the edge that make the Internet of Things possible, right? Because if you have all these drop cams that would be saturating your core or other sensors all around the planet, you have to have local intelligence to down select to the important things that you'll share. Kind of like our own systems, right? The amount of data reduction that goes on throughout our nervous system to the cortex is essential to its operation. And same for the Internet of Things. I think putting a 40-cent chip into every iRobot, every drop cam will make those products all the more intelligent, right? So you can have voice interfaces with any of them, right? Speaker independent, just like Alexa, but battery-powered devices. You could have facial recognition, object recognition in all your cameras, and so forth. So I think not just doing things for the data center, but on the other end of the spectrum, these sort of jelly bean chips that are, you know, literally tens of cents and smaller than your smallest fingernail, could be just in every device. And in theory, the dream I have is be cheaper than putting plastic buttons as an interface so you can have a voice interface or putting intelligence everywhere.